in HD.
Crews are at work now on Route 30 in York County, repairing two sinkholes that forced the closure of one lane on the busy highway. When drivers can expect the work to be done. It is our top story on News 8 at noon. Good afternoon, I'm Susan Shapiro. The sinkholes were discovered yesterday afternoon near the overpass for Schoolhouse Road in Hellam Township. Since then, it's been a slow go for motorists in that area. News 8's Pete Montine is live at the scene with an update on just how this repair work is going. Hi, Pete.
Hi, Susan. The traffic behind me is moving pretty slow. PennDOT crew is here right now, but they say their work is moving much faster here along Route 30. Traffic down to one lane. They think, though, that this work will be done by rush hour tonight. This opened up around rush hour yesterday. PennDOT workers just used a track hoe to fill in the sinkhole with a concrete mix. They say this job is a tough one, knowing this is slowing down traffic. Even more tough for them, the threat of rain this afternoon. Just felt a raindrop on my shoulder here. They say that that could slow down this process, but workers are holding out hope.
I'm confident. It seems to me that we're ahead of schedule. We're just about ready to prep for the asphalt. We'll get that in place, allow that to cool down a little bit, and open it up to traffic.
This is the second time in the last year that PennDOT has had to fill in a sinkhole here. Crews say this problem is likely from that first sinkhole a year ago. They say they just didn't quite get done with finishing and filling in all of it. The biggest challenge for crews here, they say, figuring out how deep this sinkhole actually was. A PennDOT crewman is the first person who spotted it. He said that it was about 2 feet wide and about 2 feet deep, but PennDOT crews used a jet of water to figure out exactly how deep it was and where this sinkhole started. They say that went all the way underground down about 15 feet, Susan.
Wow. All right. That's a big one. Thank you, Pete.